Slicers in Microsoft Excel are awesome. I am Chris Menard. Three things I want to cover: why use slicers, what are slicers, and the advantages and disadvantages of using slicers. So if you're filtering data already in Excel, that is a slicer. Slicers only work in tables. So let's walk through two exercises and we'll cover my three bullet points. So over in this range, A1, and it stops down in J36, this is a range. It does not say table design up here in the ribbon. Slicers only work inside of a table. I can filter a range or I can filter a table, but slicers are just for tables. So if I wanted to turn on filtering, I could go to data filter and I could filter by the different states here. One huge advantage that slicers have over filters is this. If I filter and show just California and Georgia, I have 16 of the 35 records showing. If I'm in a meeting and someone may wonder, what am I not showing in the filter? That's where slicers have a huge advantage. So let me just clear the filters and turn them off. I could leave them running, by the way. And let's create some slicers. To create slicers, at some point, you're going to, one, need to make a table. Two, you need to identify the text fields that repeat. And three, we'll add the slicers. Step number one, make a table, Control T. You can also go to Insert Table and click OK. I have a table. It now says Table Design in the ribbon. I am going to change this style just to make it something easier to see. Here are my drop-down filters, and once again, I can filter by whatever I want to. No problem there. So you can filter in a range, or you can filter in a table. In this example, I really don't need the filter, so I'm just going to turn off filter, just to keep the header row cleaner. And I want to use slicers. Here is, in the Tools group, Insert Slicer. It's going to pick up my header row. Part two of my steps, identify the text fields that repeat. I have a total of, my header row has 10 fields in it. Two fields are not text. Those two fields are purchases in column H, that's numeric, and invoice date in column G, those are date fields. Everything else is a text field that you see. The text fields that have repeating data are state, city, source, and household type. I'm just going to add three. You can always come back here and add more. So I am checking state, source, household type, and when I click OK, those are slicers sitting on my screen. So we've added our slicers, so now let's look at just moving them around and using them. You can put a slicer anywhere you want to, and you can resize a slicer. So I have three different household types. I'm going to just put it right over here. Here's my sources, and then here are my states. We'll put that. So there's the order I want them, and I just put them together right here. Here's what's so nice about slicers. Back to my example about the two states, California and Georgia. If I select California, I only see California, 7 of 35 records. But you can tell that I'm using California, but you can also tell the states that I'm not using. To use multiple states, two methods. Method one, I'm going to hold down the Control key and continue to click. When I let go of the Control key, California, Georgia, and New York are all selected in the state field. And if you notice in the source field, Google Ads and Meta are not showing up. That means they're not in any one of these three states. I can continue this. If I want to unselect, I'm going to hold Control and click New York again. Now I'm back to just these two states, and I think we lost another source here. If you want to clear the filter, you can clear the filter right here. So slicers are filters. Method two for selecting multiple items is you can turn on multi-select, or you can use Alt plus S. Now that that is pushed in, everything's selected, and it works a little bit backwards. If I click on Georgia, Georgia is not selected. So everything is selected by default. I'm just going to come through in here and just unselect some states. And there are the three states that I'm looking at right now. So either way is fine. I'm going to turn that off, and now I could go back to the Control key, but I'm going to clear it again. If you don't want to pick on state, just to show you this, I'm going to select magazine, and now I'm going to click on newspaper. When I select newspaper, notice that the household went to single, and that is true over in column J. So this is working perfectly. So now you know how to add slicers when you have a table. You also know how to move them around and resize them, and then use them with the control key. If you want to remove a slicer now, I don't want source. I'm going to click on the word source, and on the keyboard, I will press the delete key. I'm going to right-click on state. This is another method. Remove state, and then household. I'll do the same with the delete key there. So slicers are filters. Now, if you're wondering, Chris, you only worried about text field. You do not use purchases to date or invoice date. I'm going to show you why right now. If I go to insert slicer, and I'll go ahead and put both of these in here. To me, there's no reason for using this unless you want to find one specific invoice date. This is where I would not use slicers because it's numeric or dates. I would stick with my filters. The reason I would stick with filters, table design, turn on filters. You could also go to data filter. Is if I want to see purchases over 1,000, I'm going to use the number filters greater than. If I want to see invoice dates between something or after or before, I'm going to use the filter here. You can mix filters and slicers together. Example number two, and this is the Chris Menard tip for slicers. I'm going to go to this worksheet at the bottom called 2 years. I'm going to go to the bottom, control end. We have 2004 records. Back to the top, control home. I've already created the table with control T, so it says table design. Insert slicer. Two tips I have for you on this last exercise. I want to see the car brands. Just to show you this, cancel here for a second. If I select B1, I want to point out we have quite a few different car brands in here. And the other item is this. By default, a lot of people will put their slicers over to the right the same way I did in the first exercise. If I want to, slicers will print when you print this, and if you have a lot of data, I stop in F, but what if I went way over to the right to column O, column Z, it doesn't matter. This is my tip. Go ahead and just add some rows at the top. I'm going to insert 6 rows. Still in my data. Table design, insert slicer. Let's pick on the car brand, let's pick on the rep, and let's pick on dealership because the other 3 fields, we don't need them. You know this, they're date or numbers. Click OK. I'm going to put rep right here. Okay, so I've moved these around a little bit, but I'm not done. If you notice the car brands, as mentioned, we have a lot of them, so I have a scroll bar. I'm going to select brand. And now we have another contextual tab called Slicer. I'm going to select Slicer. Just so you know, it says brand over here. Here's the cool feature. How many columns do you want? I'm going to pick 2. I could go 3. I think 2 works here. Let's just pull that up a little bit. I'm going to go 3. There's 3. The dealership looks fine the way it is. And then for the rep, I'm going to select rep. And let's go 2 columns on the rep. Just to prove that this prints, if I go to File, Print, there are my slicers at the top. But now, if I had a lot of columns going from left to right, I will always see my slicers up here. And let's just use this real quick. Acura, hold down control. Let's pick GM. Let's also pick Mazda. Let go of control. 582 of 2004 records, but everyone can see what I did not use. Huge, huge fan of slicers inside of a table. One of the disadvantages of slicers, though, is one, you do have to create a table. You can't use slicers in a range. And the second disadvantage is they do not work, as we've shown, with numbers or with dates. When it comes to dates, if you had a pivot table, you have something called a timeline. I'm going to cover that in another video. Final point is if you want to get rid of all your slicers at once, again, I'm just selecting and I'm using the control key. Select them all, press delete, all the slicers are gone right here. If you use slicers and delete them or remove them, and your data is still filtered, really simple, just come up to data and hit clear, and all my data is back. And since I'm not using slicers, I would probably start this in row 1. Thank you for your time. My Excel online training class is available along with my other online training classes shown down below. Have a wonderful day.